Hey guys, today I'm going to show you these extraordinary pillars in the ancient temple of Angkor Wat. You can see right away that these pillars cannot be made using primitive tools like chisels and hammers. You absolutely have to use a lathe machine, a rotating mechanism, to create these pillars. And experts agree that this is not possible using chisels and hammers. I have already shown you large pillars in ancient Indian temples, which have been created using lathe technology. But these pillars of Angkor Wat are much more advanced. This is so advanced that it's not even possible to do it today using the technology we have. I know that's a big statement, but if you watch till the end of the video, you may agree with me. Look at the pillars here. There's something very strange about them. Yes, these marks, called turn marks, can be achieved only using lathe technology. But look at the other operations here. They did complex processes like thread cutting. This is the only way to achieve several little cylinders in the same shaft. They did another process called chamfering. So one part becomes bulgy while the other part is narrow. Imagine doing these complicated machining at least 900 years ago on solid sandstone blocks. But ancient builders were not satisfied even after processing them in a lathe machine. After this, they then carved on the faces of the pillars. There are carvings in millimeters on them everywhere. But all this is not crazy. The real crazy part is that vertical groove, the vertical line that goes from top to bottom. This is impossible to achieve even with lathe technology. You cannot make vertical grooves like this unless you use another advanced machine like an angle grinder or a circular saw today. But it's not even the vertical groove that bothers me. What's really crazy is that this line goes from the top to the bottom, and look at the depth of that groove. This is not a fancy groove made for beauty. This is a cut that was made deep enough to open the pillar into four equal halves lengthwise. Look, this is incredible. They made straight, deep lines that go from top to bottom so they could cut the pillar open into four equal halves. We cannot do this today, even with modern technology. This pillar is probably 2 inches wide. Imagine taking a cylinder made of sandstone that is just 2 inches wide, cut it into four equal halves, and put it back together to make it look like one solid piece. We cannot do this today unless we use computerized machines like CNC machines. So how did they cut solid sandstone lengthwise into four equal halves? Even more interesting, how did they glue these blocks back together so it looks like one piece even after so many centuries? Look at the perfect fitting here. This looks like woodwork, but each pillar is made of four joined pieces. This is clear evidence of ancient machining technology, but there's an important question that's even more mind-boggling. Why? Why did they have to process these pillars in lathes and then split them up only to put them back together? It's much easier to just have it as a single piece rather than cut it into four pieces and put them back together. So why did they do this? Think about it. Why would you cut something open and then put it back together? If there's no need for it, you will never cut it open in the first place. The only reason you will do this is if you have to put something inside. Today, we do this all the time when we need to keep something safe. We make a secret hole, put some valuable stuff inside, and then put it back together and pretend it's a solid box, right? We have experts who make so many secret compartments in houses. It will look solid, but if you push a button or if you use leverage, it will open up. If you see how they make these secret boxes, they take a solid piece, cut it finely, make a small room in the center, and put it back so no one can even tell it is a container holding something inside. 99% of people will just think it's one solid piece. Is this why these pillars were cut open? Because there's absolutely no other need to cut this into four pieces and then put it back together. So there's definitely something inside. What's inside? Is it somehow related to the technology that's inside Angkor Wat's main towers? In a previous video, I already showed you how there was a mysterious energy box inside the main tower's secret chamber. Now, why am I connecting these pillars and the main towers? Here's why. All these pillars are located in places where sun shines on them at particular times of the day. When sunlight is not falling on them, you don't see anything. But when sunlight falls on them, look at the shadow. Do you see what this is? Let me turn this around. What do you see now? This shadow shows Angkor Wat's temple towers. Yes, you can actually see the towers of the temple in the form of shadows. If you look carefully, you can see the central tall tower, two smaller towers, and you can even see the two towers on the sides. I mean, this is incredible. This cannot be a coincidence. And these shadows only happen on certain times of the day, on certain pillars, creating a magical effect. Is it some type of a symbol or a code pointing to an advanced technology hidden inside some of these pillars? Why else would they make such complex structures and make them even more mysterious by making the shadow in the shape of the towers? If you walk around the temple, you can see that each window is being guarded by these celestial beings called apsaras. In most other Hindu temples, these guardians are shown protecting the main chamber or major gods. But in Angkor Wat, these guardian angels are shown protecting these pillars. What is so precious hidden inside that they need to be guarded? Why were these pillars created? I'm sure some engineers will laugh at this question, right? I mean, windows, by definition, are built to let air and sunlight in. And these pillars are decorative elements in the windows. But look at this one. They made the lathe pillars, but on the other side, it's closed. And look here, and look at the entire stretch of this side of the temple. It's all completely closed using sandstone blocks. So these pillars were definitely not made as decorative elements, and these were not made as windows for sunlight or air. So what is the actual reason for making these pillars? One thing is very clear. The ancient builders definitely used advanced machining technology. They used lathe machines. They knew how to cut stone blocks like pizza, and they knew how to put them back together. But we don't know the answer to the most important question. What's hidden inside these pillars? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give it a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. And I will talk to you soon. Bye.